بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة خلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن خير الحديث كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أيها المؤمنون عباد الله، يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى: كل نفس ذائقة الموت وإنما توفون أجوركم يوم القيامة فمن زحزح عن النار وأدخل الجنة فقد فاز وما الحياة الدنيا إلا متاع الغرور. ويقول سبحانه وتعالى: أينما تكونوا يدرككم الموت ولو كنتم في بروج مشيدة. ويقول سبحانه وتعالى: قد يتوفاكم ملك الموت الذي وكل بكم ثم إلى ربكم ترجعون. ويقول سبحانه وتعالى: وجاءت سكرة الموت بالحق ذلك ما كنت منه تحيد. أيها المؤمنون عباد الله، انظروا في أعمالكم وتأهبوا لرحيلكم وانتقالكم، فإن أمامكم المخاطر والأهوال والجزاء على ما قدمتم من الأعمال. فإنكم لم تخلقوا عبثا ولم تتركوا سدى، بل تحصى عليكم أعمالكم. يقول الله عز وجل: وكل شيء فعلوه في الزبر وكل صغير وكبير مستطر. ويقول الله سبحانه وتعالى: ما يلفظ من قول إلا لديه رقيب عتيد. أمامكم الموت وسكرته، والقبر وظلمته، والحساب وشدته، وسؤال الملك وروعته، فما هو استعدادكم لكل هذه المخاطر؟ لقد ذكر الله عز وجل العباد بالموت ليستعدوا له قبل نزوله، فقال سبحانه: يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تلهكم أموالكم ولا أولادكم عن ذكر الله ومن يفعل ذلك فأولئك هم الخاسرون. وأنفقوا مما رزقناكم من قبل أن يأتي أحدكم الموت فيقول: ربي لولا أخرتني إلى أجل قريب فأصدق وأكن من الصالحين. ولن يؤخر الله نفسا إذا جاء أجلها والله خبير بما تعملون. ثبت في الصحيحين من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال: جاء رجل إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم فقال يا رسول الله: الصدقة أعظم أجرا. قال: أن تصدق وأنت صحيح شحيح، تخشى الفقر وتأمل الغنى ولا تمهل، حتى إذا بلغت الحلقوم قلت لفلان كذا أو كان لفلان. عباد الله، لقد حث نبينا صلى الله عليه وسلم على تذكر الموت وتقصير الأمل، فقال سبحانه فضلنا عليه الصلاة والسلام كما في سنن الترمذي وابن ماجه من حديث أبي هريرة قال عليه الصلاة وأتم التسليم: اذكروا هذه اللذات، قال اذكروا هذه اللذات الموت. وجاء في الصحيحين من حديث ابن عمر أن النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم قال: ما حق امرئ مسلم يكون له شيء يوصي فيه يبيت ليلتين وفي لفظ ثلاث إلا وصيته مكتوبة عنده؟ عباد الله، إن الموتى لا يتأخر عن موعده لحظة واحدة. الموت إذا جاء يختم العمل ولا تقبل التوبة. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى: إنما التوبة على الله للذين يعملون السوء بجهالة ثم يتوبون من قريب فأولئك يتوب الله عليهم وكان الله عليما حكيما. وليست التوبة للذين يعملون السيئات حتى إذا حضر أحدهم الموت قال إني تبت الآن ولا الذين يموتون هم كفار أولئك أعتدنا لهم عذابا أليما. عند الموت أيها المؤمنون عباد الله يتكشف الإنسان خطأه وصوابه وتتضح له عاقبته. فالمؤمنون عند الموت تتنزل عليهم الملائكة ألا تخافوا ولا تحزنوا وأبشروا بالجنة التي كنتم توعدون، نحن أولياؤكم في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة ولكم فيها ما تشتهي أنفسكم ولكم فيها ما تدعون نزلا من غفور رحيم. هكذا تبشر ملائكة الرحمن عباد الرحمن الذين كانوا في هذه الدنيا على إيمان وكانوا على توحيد وكانوا على سنة، تبشرهم عند مفارقة هذه الدنيا، مفارقة الأهل والأولاد، مفارقة الخلان والإخوان. قال ألا تخافوا ولا تحزنوا، أي لا تخافوا عما أنتم صائرون إليه ولا تحزنوا عما أنتم تاركوه وأشربوا بالجنة التي كنتم توعدون، نحن أولياؤكم في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة ولكم فيها ما تشتهي أنفسكم ولكم فيها ما تدعون نزلا من غفور رحيم. أما الكافر والعياذ بالله والله والفاجر فإنه يعذب ويتألم عند مفارقة هذه الدنيا. يقول تعالى: ولو ترى إذ الظالمون في غمرات الموت والملائكة باسطوا أيديهم أخرجوا أنفسكم اليوم تجزون عذاب الهون بما كنتم تقولون على الله غير الحق وكنتم عن آياته تستكبرون. عند ذلك يتمنى المرء أن يعود إلى هذه الدنيا ليصلح ما أسفل ضيع، ولكن لا يمكن من الرجوع. قال الله عز وجل: حتى إذا جاء أحدهم الموت قال رب ارجعون لعلي أعمل صالحا فيما تركت، كلا إنها كلمة هو قائلها ومن ورائهم برزخ إلى يوم يبعثون. إن الموت عباد الله لا يأخذ الصغير والكبير، يأخذ المالك والمملوك والملك والصالوك، يأخذ المؤمن والفاجر والتقي، يأخذ المؤمن والكافر والتقي والفاجر، يأخذ الغني والفقير، يأخذ الصغير والكبير. فإذا جاء أجل هذه النفس لا تتأخر قيد أم له. فالواجب على المسلمين أن يستعدوا للقاء الله سبحانه وتعالى، أن يستعدوا للأعمال الصالحة، أن يستعدوا للقاء الله بالأعمال الصالحة، للمحافظة على الواجبات وترك المعاصي الموبقات، المحافظة على توحيد الله والعمل به، والابتعاد عن الشرك والبدع والضلالات والمعاصي والموبقات. وعلى المسلم أن يتوب إلى الله عز وجل. فالله عز وجل يقول: قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. والله سبحانه وتعالى أرحم بما من أمهاتنا، أما تلك المرأة التي كانت تبحث عن ولدها فلما رأته ضمته إلى صدرها وقع، فقال عليه الصلاة والسلام: ترون هذه ملقية لله في النار؟ قالوا: ما يا رسول الله؟ قال عليه الصلاة وأتم التسليم: الله أرحم بعبده المؤمن من هذه، من الله أرحم بعبد المؤمن من هذه بولدها. وهكذا أيضا يفرح الله عز وجل بتوبة عبده المؤمن، كما جاء في الحديث: لله أشد فرحا بتوبة عبده المؤمن إذا تاب إليه من أحدكم إذا كان في أرض فلاه ومعه زاده وراحلته، فاستضم تحت شجرة، فبينما هو كذلك انفلتت عنه راحلته والتي عليها زاده وشرابه، فبحث فلم يجدها، فأخذ ينتظر الموت، فإذا هو كذلك وإذ براحلته ممتثلة أمامه. قال من شدة الفرح: قال: اللهم أنت عبدي وأنا ربك. أخطأ من شدة الفرح. فعلى المؤمن أن يرجع إلى الله عز وجل وأن يحاسب نفسه، فاليوم عمل ولا حساب غدا حساب ولا عمل. قال عبد الله بن مسعود أو قال عبد عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه: يا أيها الناس عليكم بالسمع والطاعة والجماعة، فإنها حبل الله، وما تكرهون في الجماعة خير مما تحبون في الفرقة. فعلى المسلم أن يحرص جاهدا على ما يقربه إلى الله عز وجل، وعلى المسلمين أن يتآخوا فيما بينهم. الله عز وجل يقول: إنما المؤمنون إخوة. ويقول الله سبحانه وتعالى: وإن طائفتان من المؤمنين اقتتلوا فأصلحوا بينهما. فالمؤمن المؤمن كالبنيان، كما جاء في الحديث عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام: إنما المؤمنون إخوة، إلى غير ذلك من النصوص التي تحثنا على الأخوة في الله. فعلى المسلم أن يستعد للقاء الله عز وجل بكل ما يقربه إلى الله سبحانه تعالى. أسأل الله عز وجل أن يوفقنا وإياكم لما يحب ويرضى، وأن يأخذ بنواصينا البر والتقى. وإلى هنا، وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وبالنسبة للأسئلة أعتذر، وإن شاء الله تعالى تعرضونها على الشيخ العلامة يحيى بن علي الحجوري حفظه الله تعالى في الأسبوع المقبل. وإلى هنا، والحمد لله رب العالمين، وجزاكم الله خيرا.
بارك الله فيكم فضيلة الشيخ، نسأل الله يجعل هذه الكلمات في ميزان حسناتكم ويتقبل منا ومنكم صالح الأعمال. بارك الله فيكم يا شيخ.
آمين. حياكم
حياكم الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. معذرة يا شيخ، نقول لهم السلام عليك وعلى السلام.
نعم
السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله.
For calls to the United States and Canada.
All praises due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We thank Him, we beseech in Him, we seek refuge in Him from the evils of ourselves and the burdens of our actions. Whomsoever Allah guides, there is none to misguide them. And whomsoever He chooses to go astray, there will be no one and nothing they'll be able to show him the way after he himself chose for himself his guidance to proceed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O you who believe, be fearful of Allah, as he should be feared, and die not except in the state of Islam. O mankind, be dutiful to your Lord who created you from a single person, who was Adam. From him he created his wife, who was Hawa, and from them both he created many men and women. And fear Allah through whom you demand your mutual rights, and do not cut the relationships of the wombs that bore you, because surely Allah is an ever-now watcher over you. O you who believe, be mindful and cautious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and speak always the truth. If this is done, and if you do this, he will direct you to do righteous good deeds, and he will forgive you your sins. And whomsoever obeys Allah and his messenger, he has indeed achieved the greatest achievement. To proceed, the best of the words are the words of Allah, the Exalted and High. And the best of the guidance was the guidance sent with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the worst of the affairs are the newly invented matters in the religion. Every newly invented matter in the religion is an innovation. Every innovation is a misguidance, and all misguidances lead to the hellfire. First and foremost, after we translated the Sermon of Necessity, Khutbat al-Hajj, in which the Shaykh Hafidhahullah mentioned to us, we wanted to inform you of some matters. We have with us Shaykh Hassan ibn Qasim al-Raymi, in which we had originally mentioned that we would have a Shaykh Abdul Razzaq al-Nihmi. However, for personal issues, he excused himself from being able to give us a lecture. However, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had decreed for us that we would have Shaykh Hassan ibn Qasim al-Raymi, in which, if you heard or if you were tuned in, sounded like he was tired or that he was stricken with some type of sickness or ailment. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to purify him from his sins and to make these words and this reminder in the scale of his good deeds on the Day of Judgment. Ameen. And so, he shared with us these words of wisdom. And he says, and he began with, O believers, servants of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in what translates and what it means. Every soul shall taste death, and you will be compensated for your deeds on that day, the day of judgment, the day of resurrection. You will be compensated, either good or bad, or rewarded or punished. So whoever has been saved from the hellfire and was allowed to enter paradise, then this individual has surely succeeded and is from the winners. He goes on, Hafidhahullah, may Allah preserve him, he also says, in what translates and what it means, wherever you may be, death will come to you and it will reach you, even if you were in caged up sheds. He mentions to us also in what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us and what translates and what it means. Say, verily, he will bring death to you. Malak al-Mawt, the angel of death, the one who was in charge of taking your soul, reminding us that everyone shall taste this cup of death. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in what translates and what it means, that verily, the stranglehold of death comes, and it is the truth. Is that what you try to escape? Is that what you try to run away from? Shaykh Hafidhahullah, he mentions to us and he says, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, look at your deeds. Prepare yourself for this voyage. Either this reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that in which you did. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not create you for nothing. and with no cause. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in what translates and what it means. And everything, whether it be major or minor, big or small, is something that is written. And we will see on that day, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in what translates and what it means. You don't say anything except that there's someone that is close to you, hears it, and writes it. Shaykh Hafizullah tells us and reminds us that in front of us is death. In front of us is the question of the angels in the grave. In front of us and what will come is the stranglehold of death and the trials and tribulations that afflict an individual when death befalls him. So therefore Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned us of this. Warned us from being heedless, not being mindful of this reality that will take place. Shaykh Hafizullah mentions to us the ayah in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us and what translates and what it means. O you who believe, do not be consumed and do not be fooled or sidetracked by your wealth and your children from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whoever does this and falls into this trap, and surely he is from the losers. And give from which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you from provisions, meaning for his sake, before death comes to one of you. So he say, oh my Lord, if you would just delay my death to a later date, so I can give for your cause and be from the truthful. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never delay an individual from his due measured time in which it was written for him to die. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows of all things in which you do. Shaykh Hafizullah mentions to us the hadith that was narrated by Imam Bukhari Muslim upon the authority of Abi Huraira, that a man came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he said, O Prophet of Allah, which sadaqah, which type of charity is most greatest? The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam answered him, and he says, that you give that charity, and you are healthy, and you are capable, and that you are in need of it somewhat. Shaykh Hafizullah also tells us the hadith in which was narrated by Imam al-Tirmidhi and Ibn Majah, that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam always used to remind us of hadim al-ladhat, and he used to say, remember and be cautious of hadim al-ladhat, meaning al-maut, meaning death. Death in which is, he comes to destroy every type of temptation and lust and desire. He is the destroyer of temptation and lust. Death, be mindful of it. Remember it always. Shaykh Hafizullah mentions to us the hadith upon the authority of Ibn Umar, may Allah be pleased with them both, which is also in the Sahihain, two books of Sahih, the two collections of Sahih, in which the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that it should be, and it is from the right of the Muslim, that he shouldn't go over two or three nights except that his will is with him. Meaning that he had already written his will, prepared himself for death. And so, no one is delayed or tardy from dying. Not even 1 second or 1 minute. Some people who are hastening in repenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and coming back to Him, these individuals are in great danger. Shaykh Hafizullah mentions to us the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and what translates and what they mean. that verily the tawbah and repentance, it's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For those who commit this sin, or commit these sins out of ignorance, however, they make tawbah quickly afterwards. So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, however, tawbah and repentance is not for that individual who acquires sin always until, and he is steadfast upon acquiring that sin until death befalls him. And then he says, oh, I declare my tawbah now. When death has come to him, while he was steadfast and consistent upon that sin. However, when he starts to taste this cup of death, he says, verily now I have made tawbah. Neither is this tawbah for those who die, and they are kuffar and non-believers and polytheists. And so, the people at this time of death, either they are from those who will receive the glad tidings from the angels, or they will be from those who will taste the punishment and the chastisement of their Lord. Those believers, true believers, at the time of death, the angels will come down to them and they will tell them, do not be fearful or do not be saddened, and receive glad tidings of this paradise, the one that you have been promised. Those individuals who are upon Tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who are upon the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who are the understanding of the righteous predecessors and the Salaf, when they die, these are the glad tidings that they will receive from the angels. That fear not. Fear not over that in which is to come. And do not be saddened. Do not feel sorrowful for those and those things that you left behind, from your family or from your wealth and whatnot. They will have no fear. And they should feel no sorrow. As for those non-believers, the ones that will taste this harsh stranglehold of death, those are the ones where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in regards to them, when the angels come spreading out their hands to them and telling them, take yourselves out, come out of that body. This is a recompensation for that in what you used to say and do and say upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala other than the truth. And as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us and what translates and what it means, and then when death comes to one of them, they will say, oh, our Lord, allow us to go back. Allow us to go back to life so that I may do some good in some things in which you will approve of. Or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, kalla, never. Verily it has been written. The word and the order has came down and passed. And after them, and after that, and their eternal future, is severe chastisement to the day of resurrection. And so, the Shaykh Hafizullah reminds us that this death knows no boundaries, knows no one, will overwhelm everyone and come to everyone, big or small, king or slave, man or woman, young or old. And so it is incumbent upon the Muslims. They should get ready to meet their Lord and to meet their Creator. To get ready to meet their Lord and meet their Creator with the righteous good deeds, with keeping and upholding upon the Tawheed, and establishing it in themselves, and acting upon it, and acting upon the orders and the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us to do, and staying away from the shirk, polytheism, different types of disbelief, and any state sins, whether they be major or minor, and the innovation which could lead us astray and lead us to the severe chastisement and punishment from our Lord, the Almighty. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in what translates and what it means, as the Shaykh Hafidhullah, may Allah preserve him, reminds us. He said, O Muhammad, tell my servants, the ones who have done themselves wrong, the ones who may be indulged in falsehood and in sin and done themselves wrong, do not lose hope from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives all sin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Exalted and High, is more merciful upon us than even our mothers. You think that a mother is merciful over her young and over her children, whereas Allah's mercy is a lot greater than that for His servants. As it was mentioned, in the story of that woman who had briefly lost her child. Then when she found her child, she took him and she held him and she placed him on her chest and against her chest. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, you think that this woman, you think that this mother would throw her child into the hellfire? Companion said, of course not, O Prophet of Allah. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, for verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is more merciful with us than that woman and that mother was for her young and for her child. Shaykh Hafidhullah goes on and mentions to us the story, and in the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, of that man who was so happy with when he found his camel in which was lost in the desert, in which a man had set out and went on a voyage, and he had with him his cattle or his camel in which had everything that he had and owned on it. All types of provisions, his food, his water, everything that will allow him to survive in the desert. And so, he found a tree. So he came to that tree and went to that tree. And he chose to rest. However, when he rested, he woke up. He found that his provisions have been gone. That camel had left with everything that he had. And so, he felt hopeless. He was just waiting to die of thirst and hunger. He was just waiting there until he seen it come back to him. He seen it come back, in which he said, out of complete happiness and joy, he was so joyful that he said, Oh Allah, you are my servant and I am your Lord. From the extreme nature of his happiness, he made a mistake. And so, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is happier for his servants than this individual who made a mistake out of extreme joy of finding his provisions after he had lost them. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is happier for his servants to make tawbah to him and come back to him and turn to him then this individual felt like he was about to die, and he was dying. Then he found his provisions had come back to him. And so he thanked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Muslim, it is incumbent upon him that he acts for today, and you have this life as a chance to act, because on a day of judgment, it is only judgment and no action. And we have to, the Shaykh Hafidhullah reminds us, stay with the jama'ah and the communion of the Muslims, as it is a means for us to keep this remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in us, this brotherhood and camaraderie, this advice to one another upon this truth, and upon this haqq, and an advice of one to one another upon being patient and enduring patience upon this truth and the actions and the righteous good deeds. Mentions to us the statement of Umar, may Allah be pleased with him. He says, oh people, you must uphold and be from the jama'ah, from the communion, the community of the Muslims. For what is accomplished in the jama'ah cannot be accomplished with division and partisanship and sectarianism. And so, Shaykh Hafidhullah mentions to us, hadith of Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, the believer with his fellow brethren is like a built structure, brick next to brick, and brick upon brick, strengthens one another, and strengthens the bond of brotherhood and camaraderie in this fraternity of Islam that we have with one another. And as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in what translates and what it means, verily the believers are brothers of one another, helping one another upon the good, reminding one another, and ordering one another, and forbidding the evil. And so therefore, Shaykh Hafidhullah, may Allah preserve him, Shaykh Hassan ibn Qasim al-Raymi, he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enjoin us upon this righteousness and this piety, to make us and you from those who are mindful and cautious of death, and where we could hasten and rush to act upon the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, staying away from those matters in which are forbidden. And he said that he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enjoin us upon this birr and taqwa, upon this righteousness and piety. And then he excused himself from taking any questions, for it sounded, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best, that he was very tired. And he addressed, or he instructed us that by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we are going to have Shaykh Yahya ibn Ali al-Hajuri, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserve him, that we should address the questions to him. And he said, with that, you can benefit greatly from that in which we need. And so we again want to apologize to the brothers and to our dear listeners for the shortness of this lecture. However, when an individual comes to see and ponder over the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the statements and the authentic statements of the Salaf, then it is sufficient for us. It is enough as a reminder for the believer. For verily, the reminder benefits the believer. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to benefit us and you from what we hear. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us and you in our health and in our wealth and in our children and in our health or in our free time. Ameen. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ala Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Wa jazakum Allahu khayran. Wa salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.